all ready to welcome Santa? If you've not made your Christmas cake yet and wondering what to do, I've got the perfect recipe for you. Let's make a caramel cake today. Now this is spice with the same cake spice mix that we've used in the Christmas cake. So it does give you that warm Christmassy feel too. And the ingredients for this, I'm sure, will be readily available in your pantry as well. So let's quickly check out the recipe. But before we do that, don't forget to like and share my recipes with your friends and family too. And please do subscribe to my channel too. The first step to make this cake is to caramelize the sugar. Now I've already kept the required quantity of sugar caramelized for this. If you are not aware of the process, you can just click on the link above wherein I've detailed the process of sugar caramelization. Now the quantity of sugar that I've shown in that video is exactly the same as what you need for this particular recipe. So if you're using the same measurements, you can just follow that and make sure your sugar is caramelized before you start the rest of the process. Once you have the sugar caramelized, the next step is to prepare the batter. For this, we'll first whip the eggs well before adding the sugar to it. Once the eggs have whipped, add in the sugar slowly while you're whipping. Once the egg mix has frothed up really well and the sugar is well incorporated, add in the oil slowly into this. Next goes in the vanilla essence. The dry ingredients go next. So into the all-purpose flour, let's add some baking powder first and some cake spice mix. Recipe for cake spice mix is also shared earlier, so I'll put a link for that as well for you. Now if you don't prefer that tiny hint of spices in the cake, you can skip this as well. I'll add half the quantity first, fold it well and then add the remaining half. Make sure there are no dry streaks of flour at the bottom of your bowl. Once the dry ingredients are mixed well, let's add the caramelized sugar. Once I pour the caramel, I don't prefer mixing it up completely. I like to leave that streaks of white batter and the caramelized color in the cake. So that's a personal choice, but yeah, you can always try it like this. It looks pretty. If you pour hot caramel into the batter, it will affect the consistency of the batter. You will start seeing little specks of cooked batter also, and it will affect the way the cake gets cooked. Make sure your oven is preheating at 170 degrees Celsius. I have used a 7-inch cake tin for this. You can use a 7 or 8-inch cake tin for this quantity. If you're making the cake with half the quantity, a 6-inch cake tin would work perfect. This cake takes about 45 minutes to bake. The top would have a nice brown color and a skewer inserted comes out clean. The cake baked for 45 minutes and is ready now. So make sure you let it cool down properly before removing it from the cake tin. Hope you all have enjoyed the recipe for this caramel cake and will try it out. So here's wishing you all a very Merry Christmas. Enjoy your day. Have fun.